Sean, welcome to the summer edition of the Oaklander. While you were away, we were discussing some ideas for some future shows.
That's right, Al. I think our viewers would love to see the house coat and curlers competition. Mrs. McKenzie has a real nice flower number.
No, wait a minute, Greg. The people in town want to see real issues, like UFO sightings, pygmies in the firehouse, and jello races in the park.
Get real.
Get out of here. Well, anyway, the ideas are flowing. We'd love to hear from you.
Now, check out the video and the bass player in this next one. His next appearance will be on a milk carton.
Coming to you. Bye.
Hi there, I'm Greg Schuss, director for the Oaklander. I hope you've enjoyed our show for this month. We've tried to feature artists that we've had on our program, some events we've had in town, even some local issues that we wanted to cover. We try to make our show as entertaining as possible. I'd also like to thank our crew, Jim Miller, Pete Coletta, Chris Breitfeld, and our new members, Isabel Schuss and Mary Naranjo. So don't forget to tune us in again, and you can see us right here on the Oaklander. Catch you next time.
Getting up in the morning to even bother putting some clothes on to talk to you. As a matter of fact, I think that really secretly you've always suspected this all along. So in reality, I think we could start right off the bat, and we'll just do a lot of phony baloney smiling and cover a lot of activities that we really don't care about at all. As a matter of fact, we'd rather be somewhere else entirely, except we're getting a free dinner out of this, so that's, you know, what it's all about.
You know, when I look out into your eyes, when I look out into your face,
tell us.
You know what I see? I see a little bit of Elvis in every one of you.
Oh,
that's hey. Right. Cause Elvis is everywhere. Elvis is everything. Elvis is everybody. Elvis is your king. Oh man, what I want you to see is that the beast is easy, that you and me. That's right, Elvis is in everybody. He's in everything, he's everywhere, and he's always watching you. Elvis is in your cheeseburgers. Elvis is in your jeans. That's right, Elvis is in your nutty buddies. Elvis is in your mom. That's right, Elvis is in everybody, in everything. He's in the fat people, the thin people, the old people, the young people, white people, the brown people, the blue people. Elvis is in everybody and everything. Everybody that is, except one person. There's one person who has no Elvis in him whatsoever. And that person is the evil opposite of Elvis. Anti-Elvis. And Michael J. Fox has no Elvis in him whatsoever.
No!
No, but Elvis is in everybody else, I'm telling you. Elvis is in Joan Rivers. No kidding, but he's trying to get out. Check it out, Joni.
Elvis is everywhere. Elvis is everybody. Elvis is everybody. Elvis is everything. Oh, man, what I want you to sing is it's a piece out of you and me.
You know, it's right that we should be singing this song as the King's birthday approaches. Because I know he's going to be out there in a Burger King somewhere just watching us all as we celebrate his birthday and give homage to the greatness that he was. You know, there's all those unexplained things in the universe that we all ask about, like who built the pyramids?
Elvis!
Yeah, who built Stonehenge?
Elvis!
Yes! And out of the Bermuda Triangle, you know those boats disappear, and guess what? Elvis needs boats! Elvis needs boats!
Elvis
needs boats! That's right! The sailing Elvis! Commodore Elvis!
Oh, Elvis is everywhere! Elvis is everything! Elvis is everybody! Elvis is still the king. Oh man, what I want you to see is that the beat is about you and me. You know, Elvis is there. He's out there. And when space creatures talk to me, and they do that all the time, they don't look like no Klingons or like no Dr. Spock or nothing. No, they look like Elvis!
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 Elvis! Elvis.
That's right. Elvis is a perfect being, man, and the whole universe is slowly moving towards perfect Elvisness. I mean, soon we will all be in perfect harmony, and everything will be Elvis. I mean, why do they call it evolution anyway? We know it's really Elvis-lution. That's right, it's Elvis-lution.
Elvis is everywhere. Elvis is everything. Elvis is everybody. Elvis is still the king.
Now it's time, people. It's time you reach out that little part of you deep inside that is Elvis. Talk to him. Call him up. Said Elvis, heal me.
Heal me, Elvis.
Elvis, save me.
Save me, Elvis.
Oh, let me be born again in the perfect Elvis life. Elvis, Elvis is everywhere.
Hi, Elvis is everything. Elvis is everybody, or Elvis is still the king. Oh man, oh man, what I want you to see is that
Elvis!
Elvis!
Thank you, man.
Spring, isn't it lovely? Yes, indeed. I just love this time of year. The flowers, the playground, and baseball. Well, I wish I could play baseball.
Hey, 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 kid with the funny hat, you want to play?
Who, me? Well, sure, that would be swell.
Go out in the outfield and I'll hit you some flies.
Oh, boy, this is so neat. I'm really going to play with the other kids. I'll probably make a running catch and nail the runner trying to score from third.
Let's see if you can hit my fastball.
Go ahead, Toby, throw me the heat.
Here it comes.
All right, I got it. No problem. Right here in the old bread basket, piece of cake.
Go, Frosty, go, Frosty, go! Go, Frosty, go, Frosty, go!
That Frosty gives me the chills.
Here it comes. This is it. The big moment. Oh!
Oh, no!
Oh no, he's out cold.
Are you okay, Frosty?
Maybe I'd better stick to snowballs instead.
Don't worry, Frosty. Let's get a nice cold snow cone instead.
That Frosty, he's one cool customer.
Gee, that was fun. I really like this time of year. Happy day.
Get out of here.
Yeah, what do you think you're gonna leave us with here, guys?
That's common. Yeah.
People must reach for a purpose and reinvent their lives. And now, Mr. Gorman will present us with recitations from multiple persons on set.
Good day. First of all, I think we all should thank Mr. Miller for his incredible insight on so many matters. I must say, you have straightened me out. I see things a lot more clearly.
Well, it's been worth every cent I paid you to say that.
Okay. The point-counterpoint discussion today, I think, is going to be centering on an article from the front page of the New York Times. Apparently, Hillary was mad that Bill Clinton wasn't mad, that Hillary was mad. Now, the article also mentions that Bill was aware and knew that Hillary knew that he knew that she was mad because he wasn't mad she was mad. Now, personally, I believe, I don't know about you, but I believe that if she indeed was mad because he wasn't mad, and if he became mad, then she wouldn't have been mad that he wasn't mad anymore because he would have been mad. But on the other hand, that would have left both of them mad. I think Bill Clinton took the right road, and what he essentially did was he did not become mad. So at least just one of them were mad.
Well, I'm afraid I won't have time to reply to that, but as you can imagine, well, there you have it. Bye.
Bye-bye.
Have a nice day.
Nice day.
Happy birthday, Oakland.
Happy birthday, Oakland.
I wish I could join the other kids for Halloween. It really looks like fun.
Oh my.
Frosty. Come on, Frosty, let's go trick-or-treating.
Oh, boy, this is so neat. Can I knock on the door?
Absolutely, let's go.
Let's try this house. I heard they had lots of candy.
Lots of candy. Lots of candy.
Yes.
Candy, 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 candy.
Here goes. Boy, this is... Yes, happy day.
Boy, you all look great. And if I didn't know any better, I'd swear you were a real snowman.
Yeah, sure, a real snowman.
Happy Halloween, kids. But we just ran out of candy.
No candy!
All we have left is the Breedles.
Love the Breedles.
Oh, there's a sign on the bridge, a sign on the bridge, a very pretty sign on the bridge. I wonder what it says, I wonder what it says. Then I am gonna find out.
So, Al, did you hear who got elected Torturer of the Month?
No, who?
They elected Bob. Can you imagine Bob? He's Torturer of the Month.
Oh, no, not Bob.
Oh, that could be him. He's supposed to be coming by today.
Oh, it's Bob.
I'm going to give you guys the brush once and for all. But first, I'm gonna make you talk. Ever see one of these?
Oh, look at that! Oh my God!
He's at the Hall of Repairs!
Can you sing How Deep Is My Love?
Oh, I don't remember the lyrics.
Tonight you will be twice entertained by this. Once now, and once at the end of our show. But first, some visual effects. We have target practice, starting immediately.
Oh, this is it, Al. I know it, man. This is it.
Where is the Oakland TV show?
Oh, don't tell him, Al. No matter what, man.
He'll never break me.
And you better talk.
No way.
Well, okay, suppose I dropped it. We talk now?
Okay.
Talk now? Okay.
Sure.
Works for me. Works for me. We'll be right back.
This camera though.
Recording black. You cannot see me. I am invisible right now. I work for Oakland
Ellen.
Of a very interesting guest on. This is Raja Kimo, who is the expert at many things. Raja, tell us, are you an expert at shopping malls?
The foremost, yes.
The foremost expert, okay. And have you been involved in the architecture or the planning of any new shopping malls recently?
No, I kind of drive through. I drive through them and don't buy anything most of the time.
So that qualifies you as an expert. Well, that's very good. I also understand you're an expert at high-speed racing cars. Is that true?
Yes, this is correct.
Very good. And can you tell us some of the models that you've had an opportunity to drive and test and maybe actually work on?
I haven't actually driven a Sportster car yet, as of yet, but I'm working on getting my permit.
Is that your 64 Chevy Nova out in the parking lot?
No, I do like the design, though, myself, but it's a nice-looking vehicle, but I don't have one.
Okay. Now, I understand you're also an expert at aeronautical engineering. In fact, you were involved, if I understand, in the actual architecture and design of the space shuttle. Is that true?
Actually, more like aerodynamic birdhouses. You know, I thought, why have the birds have to come down and land? Why they can just be in the air and go to their house, right? They can just be up there and go to sleep.
So does the bird actually have to land, or can it just arrive without actually even having to touch down?
I don't know. I haven't been there myself.
Okay. Now, there's also a very interesting facet that I wanted to talk to you about, because I understand you're an expert at paving. You actually paved some of the parking lots in this town. Is that true?
I even named the band Pavement. Yes. I am the Pavemeister, they might call me.
The Pavemeister. Well, thank you for joining us today, and we'll catch you next time on Meet the Expert.
Thank you. I'm taking a shortcut. It's on the road with Breit, Vell, and Schuss. We'll be right back.
That's our team, Oakland.
Hey, Greg, I just got a great idea for a public access television show.
Shut up, Al. That's the reason why we're here.
The Parent-Teacher Association of Heights Elementary School is sponsoring a fundraising event that will be reminiscent of that bygone era of drive-in movies and blue-collar factory workers. I'm talking about moonlight bowling at the Holiday Bowl on Spruce Street. Now, did I mention moonlight? Because it just don't get sleepy on us, all right? It starts at 8 o'clock and runs till midnight on Saturday, March 23rd. Come on out for three games of bowling, and don't worry if you're out of practice, because this is fun bowling. That's right, fun bowling. You need not fret over that crucial spare or that 7-10 split. Come out for a good time and a good cause. DJ music, games, prizes, and a hot and cold buffet is included in a price that we can't really say on public access television. So, for more information about this fun and crazy way to support the Heights PTA, call Kelly Enright at 337-8706 by March 15th. Don't forget, call Kelly Enright about bowling at 337-8706. Thank you.
Perfect. Greg, you made that one.
We're here at TCI Studios to bring you the announcement by F.T. Snowman that he has thrown his hat into the ring and has joined the race for president. This is quite the unexpected turn of events and has thrown the entire presidential race into turmoil. There has been a report that Frosty was involved in a slush fund to finance this campaign, but he has confirmed to this reporter's satisfaction that indeed his assets are frozen. Frosty has been a model citizen and inspiration to the children of America. He even has the backing of a Mr. Kris Kringle, who said that Frosty is one cool customer who will not back down in the face of adversity. Unless, of course, the sun is shining and the temperature is over 32 degrees Fahrenheit. We now take you to TCI Studios, where Mr. Snowman will address the media. For the Oaklander, this is Greg Schuss reporting.
I would like to thank the members of the media for being here today as I announce that I intend to run for the presidency of the United States of America. America needs a new face, and I am that face, a face you can know, a face you can trust, and will lead this nation to new heights of greatness not seen before. Working with a solid team of workers in the farm world, we know who's naughty and who's nice. We shall rise upon this nation for truth, justice, and one and all. With freedom to let everyone seek out their own destiny. Many have asked me on the campaign trail, what can Frosty do for me? My reply is, what would you ask of a snowman that you could not ask of yourself? Let us join and work together for a better future. That is all we have to say at this time. A vote for Frosty is a vote for America. Thank you. And my God bless you and us all.
And now for these kind words from Chris and Greg.
Hi, I've got Chris on the phone, and we're working on the next Oaklander production. You cannot
Cannot. Listen, I told you. No, that's not gonna work. You have no idea. Listen to me. Hold on. I got another call. Oaklander TV. Well, hi. Sure. Tuesday afternoon? Let me check my schedule. Tuesday looks good. Around 4:30? Sure. We'll show up with two cameras. We have a crew of about 4 or 5 people. And we'll tape the whole thing. Yeah, no problem. Good. All right, we'll see you Tuesday. Bye. Chris. Yeah, somebody wanted us to come down and tape something. Listen, you gotta get your act together. Yeah, that's right. I'm talking to you. What do you mean? Listen to me. There's no way that's gonna work. I'm sorry. Forget it. No, I don't even want to talk about it. Listen, I have to go. Bye.
As you can see, our team is working in perfect harmony.